On a recent podcast, Nate Shot and some other 100T employees talked about LA Thieves, how much money they lost, and gave hints about the future of the team. And as an LA team fan myself, I figured I'd keep you all updated, especially as this pertains to Roster Mania. First things first, let's talk about the money they lost. Now, John Robinson, their president and COO, said that the LA Thieves team lost $2.5 million in their World Championship season. Now, this encompasses a lot of different expenses, not just player contracts and staffing, things that go along with content, travel, all that sorts of things that go into, you know, running a team goes into this. And I also am not sure if the money that they spend is included in whatever they spend for their franchise spot every year, but they lost $2.5 million. So they spent more than $2.5 million, because if they lost $2.5, that's not including any of the money they made. So they spent a lot of money on the LA Thieves for one season. And due to how much money they lost, they want to stabilize the business, obviously get closer to at least breaking even and trying not to spend nearly as much as they have been. So this leads me to my second point as to kind of the hints they dropped in regards to what the future LA Thieves team is going to look like. Now, they didn't give any names, but there were a couple things mentioned across the podcast, which can lead us to believe sort of what they're going to do for this team. One of the things that Nate Shot said is they're looking forward to bringing in young and hungry players. Obviously, one of the big topics of this being about their finances and their budget. They, of course, were talking about bringing in more of a budget team and something that's a little bit cheaper than what they had been spending previously on their superstars. They also made note about the players coming onto the team aren't going to be as, you know, recognizable or star noticeable as we saw with their previous team. Obviously, all four guys on their team last year are very much, you know, personalities and somewhat stars in the league. And so this team is going to be very different. And then another thing that they mentioned, which I think is very interesting, is they mentioned that they were excited to be underdogs again. Obviously, when they first got into the league in Cold War, they kind of were underdogs because their team didn't really look that good on paper. And then recently they've been, you know, top teams winning in Vanguard, winning last season as well, Major. So they're looking forward to being underdogs once again. But that sort of leads me along to what my guess is what the LA Thieves team is going to look like. And my best guess is we're probably going to see at least a couple challengers players, and then maybe some pros that are looking to revitalize their career, or people that have kind of been, you know, just solid role players in the league that would be willing to come onto the team for, you know, a reasonable contract. In terms of the challengers players, there's obviously a huge pool of challengers players they can bring in. Do they bring in someone like Abuza or one of these top challengers? I'm not exactly sure, because I personally have no idea what those players would be looking for when it comes to a contract, and also how many teams are trying to offer them contracts. I have no idea what that looks like behind the scenes, but seeing some top challengers players or some good challengers players come into this team, I think is highly likely. I think it's possible we also see some veterans or some players that have been in the league already that maybe don't have the biggest, you know, like name value and star value, and also might be willing to take a somewhat cheaper or more budgeted contract. I don't really know who those guys could be. I mean, just trying to think like off the top of my head, and maybe a guy like Asim or somebody like TJ Halley, someone like Mac, Accuracy, you know, guys like that, that maybe, you know, still can have their spot in the league, but might be willing to come play for a team that has a big fan base like LA Thieves on somewhat of a cheaper contract. Another interesting thing to think about is if they go the route of challengers players, there's always the possibility that they strike gold, kind of like Surge did with Pred, or, you know, we've seen with like Hydra and other rookies that have come through in the past. Maybe you find a rookie that is so, so good that someone wants to buy them out from you, and that can even generate you more money. Because I think at the end of the day, they're really looking at trying to stabilize the business, like I said earlier, which I personally have no problem with as an LA Thieves fan. I think, you know, you got to keep the business afloat more than anything else, obviously. So maybe bringing in some guys that might be able to up their value and maybe you can sell on in the future could be a really interesting way to go about it. But that's basically a quick update for anyone kind of wondering what the LA Thieves Roster Mania is going to look like. I think we're going to start seeing some things from them maybe somewhat soon based on the way they were kind of talking about it, and sort of it seemed like they had a pretty good idea about what they were going to do based on the way they talked about it on the podcast. But obviously they didn't want to give any names, so maybe we see something from them soon. And of course, make sure you sub to this channel, as I will keep you up to date on everything Roster Mania, and I make a ton of other CDL content. So with all of that being said, make sure to drop a like, and hopefully I'll see you all in the next video.